Hi everyone, welcome to a crochet tutorial with me, Laura, at Happy Berry. And in this video, in this tutorial, we're going to be making this very cute little wrap bag or pencil case or crochet hook case or whatever you would like to use it for. And it's definitely a beginner-friendly design, I think. It uses a very simple variation of the half double crochet or half treble in UK terminology. So rather than just repeating the half double crochet, we're going to mix it up a little bit and do something a bit more interesting to create a nice stitch design. And along with that, I'm going to be showing you how to slip stitch neatly along edges where there are no proper stitches. So let's begin, shall we? So for this tutorial, we're going to need two separate colours. I mean, you can use one colour, but I like to have two different colours. And I've chosen a green, a sort of lime green colour, and a grey. And this is a yarn weight of around 2 or 3, so a sort of DK light worsted weight yarn. And with that, I'm using a 3mm crochet hook. And it's also a good idea to have a pair of scissors and a yarn tapestry needle as well. So let's begin, and we're going to start off with the basic stitch that we need to create two panels. We can end up with two panels. And the basic stitch, just starting along here, is a really simple stitch, and it's just a nice variation to normal half double crochets. And I'm going to show you in the grey. So what we're going to do first of all is create a little slip knot with our yarn, and we're going to chain 36. So chain 36 to begin. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Keep going. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35 and 36. So this is going to be the width of our pencil case or crochet hook case. You can obviously chain more and make a wider case if you want to. But what we're going to do next is we're going to do some half double crochets. Now this pattern's in US terminology, so in UK terminology that's going to be a half treble. We're going to yarn over. We're going to go into our second chain from our hook, so we don't count the loop on our hook. There's our first chain, there's our second, and we're just going to go into there and do a half double crochet, like so. And we're going to do that all the way across, so you want to do one half double crochet in each chain across, and the next chain. Another half double crochet until you end up with 35 half double crochets. So I shall do that and then I shall come back. So just one half double crochet in each chain across to the end. So just coming up to the end. Just continuing with our half double crochets, and you should have a total stitch count of 35. Okay, so you should have something that looks like this. You can obviously do the half double crochet foundation stitch as well if you want to, but I thought this would be a little bit easier for absolute beginners, so it's achievable for everyone, hopefully. Then what we're going to do is we're going to start the main pattern. You could continue just doing half double crochets, but I thought let's make it a little bit more interesting. So we're going to chain one and turn. Don't count your chain ones as a stitch, that's just for leverage. We're going to start off yarn over with just one half double crochet in that first stitch. One half double crochet. I'm going to do one half double crochet in the next stitch as well. But then what we want to do is a half double crochet around the previous
half double crochet. So you want to put your hook in between those half double crochets and then grab the yarn, and just wrapping it around the previous half double crochet, we create another half double crochet. So it's kind of horizontal. And because we've added a stitch there, we now need to take away a stitch. So we're going to yarn over and do a half double crochet, two stitches together. So we yarn over, go into the next stitch, bring the yarn through, yarn over again and go into the next stitch, bring the yarn through. So you should end up with five loops. Yarn over and pull through all five loops to do a decrease. And your stitch count should have gone back down to what it's supposed to be. Then we're just going to repeat those two techniques all the way across. So in the next stitch, we do a half double crochet, just a normal one. Then we yarn over and we wrap our next half double crochet around the previous half double crochet. So we go in between our decrease and this half double crochet, put your hook in there, bring the yarn through, and wrapping it around the previous stitch, we do a half double crochet. Then we do a decrease again. So we yarn over, go into the next stitch, bring the yarn through, yarn over into the next stitch, bring the yarn through, five loops, yarn over, pull through all five loops. And we just repeat that all the way across up to the last stitch. So again, to show you again, we do a normal half double crochet in the next stitch, yarn over, put your hook in between the decrease and the half double crochet, that gap there, then wrapping around the previous stitch, we do a half double crochet, then we half double crochet two together, yarn over to the next stitch, five loops, pull through all five loops. So I'm going to repeat that all the way across until I get to the last stitch. And that is the main pattern. So we end up just repeating this for the duration of the design. So I shall do that and then I shall come back once I'm at the last stitch. So again, one more time, normal half double crochet. Put your hook in between the decrease and the half double crochet. Wrapping it around the previous stitch, do a half double crochet and then decrease. Half double crochet the next two together. Okay. So you should have four stitches left, and again we're just going to do one half double crochet in the next stitch, then go in between the decrease and the half double crochet, and then wrapping it around the half double crochet, we do another half double crochet, then we half double crochet the next two stitches together. That brings us to one remaining stitch right on the corner here. We just finish with just a normal half double crochet. So just a nice normal half double crochet. So that's the main stitch design, and we're just going to repeat that for another 35 rows or until your project measures about 24 centimeters. So again, to show you quickly, we just do a little chain one, turn, don't count that as a stitch, and we start off with exactly the same as the previous row. We just start off with a half double crochet, and then a half double crochet in the next stitch. Then we yarn over and go in between those half double crochets, and then work a half double crochet around the previous stitch. Then we half double crochet the next two together, and we repeat the pattern just like the previous row. So in the next stitch, half double crochet, put the yarn in between the decrease this time and the previous stitch, and do a half double crochet, half double crochet the next two together. So just repeat this pattern for another 35 rows or until it measures about 24 centimeters. And you want to create that for two panels. So I've got one in grey and one in green. So Hopefully you can pause this video now and create two beautiful panels using this stitch, and then I'm going to show you what to do next with the green one here, which is, this one's finished. As you can see, I've got a nice slip stitch around the edge, but this one needs finishing, so I'm going to show you how to do the slip stitching once you have done your next 35 rows. So I'm just coming up to the end of my second panel. So I've done one panel in gray and I'm just finishing up the second panel in green. So again, just finishing up the last four stitches, we do one half double crochet. And then we go in between the previous decrease and the half double crochet, do another half double crochet. Then we half double crochet two stitches together. Five loops. Then we finish up with one half double crochet in that very last stitch. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're just going to do a nice slip stitch edging around the whole project. So I'm just going to do a little chain one again, don't count that as a stitch, and turn. And just going into each stitch, we're going to do a simple slip stitch. So just go into that first stitch, do a slip stitch, and we're going to slip stitch all the way across to the other side. So keeping a stitch count of 35 or whatever stitch count you're using. So I'm just going to do that, slip stitch all the way across till I get to the other side. Okay, so just coming up to the end. Slip stitch to the end. And once you get to the very, very last stitch, what we're then going to do is we're going to work one slip stitch neatly across this edge, across the bottom, across your chains, which should be a little bit easier, and then neatly across this edge as well. So what you want to do to create a nice slip stitch edge where you don't have proper stitches is try and create a pattern. And what I found is, where, if you can see here, you can see these sort of very gentle lines in the pattern here. And each little group here represents two rows. So per two rows, I do two stitches and then a little extra one in between on the actual line. So we do two slip stitches, then one in the middle, two slip stitches, one in the middle. I do that all the way across and I'll show you close up. So I find a piece of yarn to go under. So I can see here, I've got this little single piece of yarn. I'm going to slip stitch into there and be consistent with your slip stitches and it'll make it nice and neat. Then the next one, I've sort of got almost a proper stitch. So I'm going to go under that, if I can. So I'm going to go under those two little loops and do a slip stitch in there. And then we want to do a slip stitch in the middle on the line. And you can see there's a little hole there. So we're going to slip stitch into there. And I'm going to follow that technique all the way across. So again, I'm going to look for that little single loop and do a slip stitch. Then we've got almost a proper stitch. So I'm going to go under two loops. If I can get that, a little bit fiddly on camera. Do a slip stitch in there. And again, we do one in that hole along the line, slip stitch into there. So I'm going to do that all the way across, and then I'm going to slip stitch across the bottom, then up the other side, following a similar technique to here. So just try and be consistent with your slip stitches. You should have the same structure of stitches on the other side as well to follow. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to come back. And hopefully we'll have a nice finished second panel and we can start joining our pencil case or crochet hook case together. Okay. So you can see that's creating a nice neat edge that's not pulling or distorting the shape of the project. Should sit nice and flat. Okay, so I shall do that and then I will come back. So when you get to the end, we're going to follow the same system, go onto that little one bit of loop, do a slip stitch, and then we sort of kind of then just only have like a hole. So just do it as neatly as you can up into that very last, or that first chain that you created along there. And then we're going to move into crocheting into these chains, which hopefully will be a little bit easier because you'll have proper stitches. So we're not going to add any extra stitches on the corner. We're just going to go straight into that chain and do a slip stitch and slip stitch all the way across. Now your chains might look a little bit different depending on how you crochet, but just hopefully you've got semi proper stitches you can work into, but just work to a stitch count of 35 across the bottom. And just going to do that and then work up the other side as well. Just coming up to the other side across the bottom, working into that last chain. And then we want to work stitches neatly up here. And we're going to follow the same system, work two slip stitches per little group here, and then one on the line join all the way up. So you should end up with about 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 54. So about sort of 54, 56 stitches across the edge. So I haven't actually counted. So, but just make sure it's consistent and the same each side, and make sure it's the same for your second panel as well, because obviously we want to join these together and have matching stitches. So again, I'm going to look for sort of stitches I can work into, and we should have a sort of similar structure. So I'm just going to go into a stitch there, this row at the end, and then again I'm just going to go onto that one loop, and then under sort of like a proper stitch, you can kind of see there, under two loops. And then we want the one in the middle, sort of along this line, you can see. You should have like a little hole in the middle there. Go in there, there we go. So I'm gonna do the same for this side, and then I'm gonna come back and we're gonna hopefully join these pieces together. So again, under one loop, under almost a proper looking stitch, two loops, and then one in the middle in this kind of hole here. Okay. Okay, so just coming up to the very end, this second side is one little extra stitch on the corner, and we are done. So we're going to cut our yarn, just pull that through, and hopefully you've got something that looks like this, with nice neat slip stitches and no distortion to the shape of the project. And you obviously want two of these panels. So what we're going to do now is we're going to join these together. We're going to sew these together. And we want the slip stitches to be on the outside. So what we want to do is have wrong sides together. There's never any wrong sides, but we're going to put our wrong sides together. And what I thought would be nice is to have like a little sort of opening just at the top, a little slip there. So we're actually going to start sewing from about 1 inch down, just a couple of centimeters. And we're going to sew all the way along there, across the bottom and up to the other side, stopping just again 1 inch from the top. And this is going to be left unsewn because obviously we want it to be a bag. So pick a color. Obviously, I don't know if to use green or gray, so I think I'll probably just go with what I have the most yarn with. I have a little portion of the green here, so I think I'll start sewing with the green. Okay, so, and imagine this as the top. I'm going to sew these ends in at the end. I'm going to get the yarn needle, and this is where our slip stitches are going to come in useful. So it's going to untangle this mess. And we're going to count from the top. So I want this to line up pretty well. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 4 stitches I'll leave empty. And then going into the next stitch, I'm just going to go into the top loop. So rather than going under both loops of the slip stitch, I'm just going to go under the top loop. I want to join that up with the other side. So find your slip stitches from here, count 1, 2, 3, 4 down. And in the fifth one, we then want to go into the bottom. So we're going to leave that top stitch empty. And that's how I'm going to sew these together with a little whip stitch. So leave a little bit of length there. I'm just going to reinforce that by going through that twice. Okay, turn in, getting in the way. And I'm going to repeat that for all the slip stitches around this edge, along the bottom and up the other side. So find the next slip stitch. And again, just go under the top loop, find the other side and go under the bottom loop. Do a little whip stitch. Hopefully your tail ends won't keep getting in the way. And again, for the next stitch, under the top loop, find the other side, and then on the bottom loop. And the next stitch, top loop, and then the bottom loop, that slip stitch. Careful not to grab any other bits of the project, like under here, any of these loops. You just want to get just that bottom loop. Okay, so I shall do that and then I shall come back and hopefully we'll have something that's almost finished. Oops, let's see there, I've gone under an extra loop, so I just want to make sure we're just catching that slip stitch, which is easier said than done. So I should do that and come back, and hopefully you won't get into a tangled mess as much as I am. Okay, so I finished sewing along there, across the bottom and up the other side, just leaving a little 1-inch opening there just because it looks nice. You don't have to do that, obviously, and hopefully your sewing will look something like this, these little whip stitches, and it doesn't show too much. And that's a good thing about doing the slip stitches, because it just means your sewing is quite consistent, matching up the slip stitches. So all that's left to do now is I'm just going to reinforce that last stitch that I made. Move this tail end out of the way. So I'm just going to go back into, it gets a little bit twisted, the yarn, when you've been sewing with it for a while. So I'm just going to go back into there and just reinforce that last stitch and then cut the yarn. Actually quite good because that's how much I had left. And all that's left to do now is the strap. So if you've done two colours like me, then pick your kind of favourite outside colour. I think I might have a grey bag with a green, it looks a lot more yellow in here, sort of a lime green strap. So because my bag is going to fold this way, so the green is on the inside, and for a bit of contrast I want the strap to be in green. So I'm just going to put that to the side, grab our green yarn once you've made your choice, and we're going to crochet, I'm not sure how many we're going to need, probably about 60 or 70 chains. So you just need to guesstimate to begin with and then see if it's long enough for you. So I'm just going to chain about 70 stitches. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I shall do this and then I shall come back, so we could be here a while. 10, 11, 12. Okay, so I've actually chained 100 chains in the end. 70 wasn't enough, so I've done 100 chains, and then we're just going to cut our yarn and pull the loop through. We've just got this nice long length of hopefully quite neat chains. And what we're going to do is find the center. So you've got, this is your favorite color side, and I'm just going to fold it over, and then so it's going to wrap like this. So turn it over. Then on the back here, I want to find roughly the middle, and we're going to, I'm probably going to use a yarn needle for this actually. I'm going to thread this through our project, being careful not to go through the greens. So if we open this up flat, put your hand inside, so find roughly the middle. And we're going to find some quite big stitches. So maybe go through here, come out here, and we're going to pull that through. So needle's done its job, and that's just going to sit inside like so. So yeah, just make sure that's not gone through to the green side. We want it nice and loose. You can sew this into place if you want to, but that should be enough. And then your bag is finished. So all that's left to do is obviously hide these tail ends, maybe neaten up the edge here. But the idea is we fold and we fold, and then this on the back wraps around to the front, and we can tie this into place. So do a little bow, like so. So I'm going to tidy up these tail ends so you can see it a lot better, and then we can come back and look at the finished bag. And there we go, I've tidied up my tail ends, and I've just neatened off the ends here by just sewing back through the chains so it creates a nice tight knot. Actually, that one wasn't very tight, so I've just tightened that. And there we go, and the bag is finished. So all that's left to do now is to actually use it. So we do again, we just fold it over, and taking our strap here, we can then keep it closed by using the strap that we just created, which could probably, I don't know if that's long enough or not, so you'll have to decide if that's too small or too long for you. But I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope that was a kind of beginner-friendly project.
So I really hope you enjoyed that tutorial, and this pattern, the main design, can easily be adapted with any stitch. So just creating two panels, sewing them together, makes a really cute little wrap bag. And you could use this as a pencil case or as a crochet hook case or even for storing your yarn. It's completely up to you. But that's it from me, Laura at Happy Berry, and thank you for joining me today. See you soon. Bye.